der Stritzi spielt Milia?
Ist doch Stritzi. Nee, das ist. Nein, das ist. Wir haben zwei Neulinge, also GG-Neulinge im Dojo, Stritzi und Insta. Okay. Insta ist der, der Milia spielt, Stritzi spielt Sol.
Ah, okay.
Weihnachts-Sol, um genau zu sein.
Der verteilt die Geschenke.
Sollen wir nicht auf Englisch?
Ja, wir sind noch nicht live.
Ach so.
Ah, alright.
Okay, we're live.
Hello and welcome to the
welcome
Guilty Gear
good morning
tournament.
Or good evening, wherever you're looking, wherever you're watching. We got some Guilty Gear action for you.
Right now, first round winners, Mephistopheles versus VDV Stritzi.
Yeah. And we are, our names are, myself, I'm VDV owner.
And I'm MFN Lunific Soul.
Both competing in the tournament and, well, we don't know, our matches are on hold right now. So luckily we can commentate this action here. And we see some strong Batman play.
Right now, maybe in control.
Yeah.
In control. He has a really, really well lapped out style.
Yeah, I heard he leveled up with Batman.
Yeah, he's
he tried
really
out Raven,
scary.
But yeah, dropped it.
Yeah,
stay true to your origins.
Yeah. He has like really scary setups, especially in the corner if you get knocked down. It's
yeah, that's Batman for you.
Oh man.
But with some seals he can control the neutral just as well.
Yeah.
And here we
now
have some falling bats. Oh,
alright,
no,
nice
no.
avoidance with the puffin here. Alright, RC
oh,
for the pressure. Ooh!
5D!
Nice.
Okay, that,
okay,
was,
that was an execution error, yeah, for sure. Right now, corner pressure. Oh my, this.
Oh.
Alright, he doesn't get the knockdown, so he can't go into his
yeah, maybe
vortex.
He struggles with his Oki. Kudakke Rock.
Alright.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, the sheep is coming
this
out.
Looks like a done deal.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Well, not much he could do.
Right from a horror movie.
So, Murphy goes up 1-0.
And right then we'll rematch.
So,
ooh. Press the start with
goes for a round start, Bandit Revolver. Not a thing you see often.
Okay, get some low.
Ooh.
Dude, you have to finish your combo. Okay, that was an OTG burst. No much punish for that.
Oh my god, run up 5D.
Yeah, yeah. Backdash from Batman is pretty good.
Oh my,
okay, wake up 5D again.
There.
Riot Stomp. Ooh, I think the Clash moved to 6P.
Yeah. Alright, now
bats
now
we falling.
Can go into what? No.
Counter Assault? No, you're staying that corner, sir.
Matthew, right now, respecting Shlizzy a lot. Actually.
There we got a knockdown from Sol.
Again?
He had the meter. He should have gone for Gunflame YRC.
Yeah. But I don't think like continuous run-up 5Ds are going to pay off.
This was the third time in a row and he blocked it. So yeah, you should go low now.
Alright, now
it's
getting knocked down
safe.
In the corner. This is gonna be oh
6H?
He respects the DP
into
and gets 6H'd. Ouch.
Do we see the rise of Turbo Sol? When's Turbo Sol?
Alright. Air grab into cross up. He needs the RST to make it safe.
He will spend that meter.
Oh,
Gunflame
nice.
Gets thrown. Yeah, the throw range on Batman is extraordinary.
Yes. Oh my. Also, Mephi is using it really well. You can't, like, see it coming ever. Alright.
Okay, no.
Now pushing Mephi to the corner bit by bit.
Oh, 5K anti air, but doesn't follow it up.
Alright, that was actually a good burst. It was pretty good.
Yeah, we got run up throw. Batman can actually do run up throw in his mix up. Right, stop.
Right. Oh,
no 6P, you had all the time of your life.
Oh my. Right now, he's trying to grind him out.
And
that should be
2-0 for Mephi. Or Mephistopheles. That's what his full name is.
Alright, next up on stream we got Anti-Zaito versus Acid Hell. Anti-Zaito plays Emilia. He's been leveling up every time I've seen him so far.
Anti-
not Emilia.
Eno.
Yeah. Acid Hell, I think I...
Kai. I played him casuals. He's got a really solid Kai, so...
This should be interesting.
Yeah, this should be
like,
really interesting.
If Anti can put him in the blender, maybe he can get stuff going.
Both chars have good Oki.
Yeah, for sure. I think, I don't know if Anti-Zaito has Kai experience though. That's the thing. He's not proficient in as much matchups as he maybe should be. Mm. So we'll see. I think he had some chances to play with Yosh earlier.
Ah,
in earlier tournaments.
Yeah.
Alright.
Alright, you're leaving.
My match has been called, so I'll leave Ona on commentary for now.
I'll do my best. Maybe someone else will join me. I'll see. Yeah, guys, if you're already on stream watching, give us a feedback if the stream is somehow wrong, bugged, or something else. Our technician will take care of it. We got a real pro at it. Shoutouts to Fight Club NRW, Hadouken.eu. Yeah, and always check. When I fought him in casuals, Adset Hell needed the 2-frame lag because he plays Cab, I think. I think he is goes regularly to Japan, maybe because of his job. I didn't ask much further into the topic, into the issue. But that's not that important. What's more important is who gets the first knockdown in this matchup. This should be the deciding factor. Oh yeah. Pick a good BGM. Sky should be high. One of the better themes. Vocal themes, actually. And we are in the colonies. Now the zoning begins. No one wants to go in. Ino zoning is pretty much two things. Either chemical love horizontal or the note. Or stroke the big tree goes mid-screen. Goes under projectiles and can only be beaten by a lows. Okay, dives. Ah, tries to go for the cross though. Here we have the open situation. He gets a free in. Adset Hell could have used his meter. There he goes. Yep, early burst. Ino cannot risk the knockdown. Now Ino, yeah, he got that combos. Does not get the follow-up. Note goes out, just hits him in the air. Split CL is out. Ooh, that's minus, sir. And we go for charged. Ooh, blocks the online unblockable. Oy, wake up throw. That was actually quite risky. Because that was no OS, because it was a back throw. The OS is with forward throw and 6P. Oh, tries to go in with the stunnage, but Ino is too fast. I'm not quite sure if the hover dash goes over over the slide. Okay, pressures him. Tries to get him out with FD. One of Ino's rare defense options. She has to rely on system mechanics. Apart from her reversal super, which is plus on block, or at least safe. I think it's plus one, and it puts you at a decent range. But Kai has now all the meter. He needs to spend it. If he gets to spend it. Oh, bro. Yeah, Antai needs to make those Ino approaches much more safe. Since in Guilty Gear, throws are zero framers. Or one framers, I'm not quite sure what it is. Anyway, they are really fast and you cannot leave a one frame gap too close in your offensive. So, one up for Adset Hell. Let's see if Antai can adapt to the playstyle. Oh, now he gets the cross up. However, it's just one hit. For more hits, you should have wire seed. And there we go. One of Ino's better approaches is Cortiel, vertical chemical law into wire seed, which eats up all your it eats up all your inputs you've made beforehand. Okay, names are wrong. I can see that. I unfortunately can't see that because I only see the game footage and not the stream. However, I can see the chat, so feel free to ask or comment on my performance here. And we got a second comment, everyone.
Hello.
Owner.
How are you? How are you? Oh, yeah, I'm fine, I'm fine.
Didn't sl-
Okay, thank you.
So, all right.
Tries to go for greed server.
What's the score right now?
The score is 1-0 for AZ Hell, the Kai player.
Yeah.
But Antai is fighting back, has one round up.
Okay.
Bursts out. Okay, projectiles. Yeah, you can...
Oh, there was the greed.
You can maneuver the note on your own. So, note is one of the better projectiles. And the more range you traverse, the more hits it gets. You see, that was 5 hits. On max range, it gets like 9 hits or 8. I'm not really sure. It's the more, the faster, the. Okay.
Oh, nice.
Okay, Antai, 1-1. I have to leave. My match is getting late. Be back soon.
Okay, 1-1. The projectile tries to go for the corner reset. Do you mean the projectile with the including jump? I think it's only the range between the two characters, if I'm not mistaken. If you tag a neither move, it has a lower startup. There's the reversal. Yeah, I think it's between the two characters. Okay, so at commentary, the one and only Lunatic Soul or Lunatic Soul.
So, let's see. So, welcome stream. The match has been going on. Is it still Antai Saito versus...
Antai Saito versus Azatel. It's 1-1.
Match point Azatel. Yeah. I see. All right.
He gets a combo, the anti-air combo.
All right. Now, nice 5k. They got them in standing lows. I hate those moves. All right. Kai's jump age actually really strong in this matchup, but he must have mistimed it. All right. Oh, he could have gone for a really strong punish there. That's if you instant block the second hit, most characters can like run up S or something.
Which second hit from the
from the slide?
From the grid server.
Grid server.
That was the way.
All right. Gets the 5D. A really strong move for Kai, especially on normal block. It's plus minus zero, so you can just throw it out if you have the pressure. Oh, he misses his air dash combos. That's gotta hurt, man. That's gotta hurt. He could have had a good chunk of life taken out and a solid Oki, but sadly misses his combo. This game absolutely punishes you for not being on point.
Still here in a nutshell, right?
Yeah, totally. All right.
All right. What's next match on stream?
I don't think it has been called out yet. Okay. How did you do in the first round?
I won.
Resell didn't show. All right.
Good play. Thank you, man.
Best Tesh.
And now I have the honor to play against Rasta, you know, probably one of the best European players.
Oh yeah, his Faust is so strong.
Yeah,
I mean, he won the last two Guilty Gear tournaments in last two Dreamolition derbies, and he's definitely favored to win this again.
Yeah.
Like, there's no doubt, Rasta is the strongest contender right now.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, no, nobody would. So,
a player to look out for, to watch out for.
What is your secret tech against Faust? Tell us.
Lying on the floor, try not to cry a lot.
I see. Yeah. All right, that's a good plan against Rasta.
Like,
Rasta is one of those players. I mean, he's so much better than you, but he still plays a solid game.
Yeah.
Oh. I gotta play on stream right now, so I'm sorry. I will be back at some point.
Gegen wen?
Oscar.
So Lunatic Soul has to play.
Don't let Reno sit here alone, because nothing good will come out of Reno get compensated alone.
Fuck you!
Oh, shit.
You didn't hear that. So they're setting up right now.
So with me is Vitizen.
Yep.
Oh, he knows my name.
Yeah, I know your name. Do you know mine?
Yeah, I heard it just now. But yeah, we're gonna see Macho versus Lunatic now. I don't know enough about the game to properly comment on what's happening, but I know that Lunatic has been practicing a lot lately.
Yeah.
He's been practicing like... he said he was practicing 1 week just P-moding and making sure that his combo sits.
Yeah, I know that.
And Mo, on the other hand, used to be pretty good at Guilty Gear, but he kind of dropped the game.
Oh, okay.
Even back in Cologne, at the tourney in Cologne, he didn't play Guilty Gear.
Okay. So
he's kind of out of the loop. So it's going to be interesting because Lunatic is new and Mo has been playing the game before, but hasn't really been playing regularly lately. He's mostly been focusing on Street Fighter and also KOF now. Yeah. So let's see what's gonna happen then. Oh, never mind, I have to play.
Fitzen has to play. Okay, so it's Lunatic Soul versus Mo. Starts off with Fafnir. There's the burst. Tries to go for a reset. Oh.
Danke. he cancels the ground wiper. And there comes the dust loop with a high guts rating. That will be really, really bad. Okay, the reject, but can capitalize on it. The counter, and this should be run. Yeah.
Oh, he counters him, misses the coin. The counter clap here.
Yeah, if Soul hits you once, then you're probably half dead. Mo tries to zone him here, but oh hey. I want to say that he isn't really getting this. He can zone him out, but he did a good job there. Lunatic in the corner, but gets the content. But there's the burst from Mo. The content, the coin, the Fafnir, and the wild throw. Juggles him into the corner. Now comes Loki. Oh, the counter assault. But Lunatic can't punish that. He missed it. Okay, there comes the wild throw. Oh, Lunatic drops the combo. And the first legendary from the first round goes to Lunatic Soul. And will we see another character? Yeah, Kai. For everybody who wants to learn Guilty Gear and is a Street Fighter player, Kai is a good character to start because he is pretty much plays with his normals and is a good character at zoning. Names are wrong. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Geomantic. Okay, and he jumps over the projectile. Okay. If the 6H hits you on block, it's plus 15, I believe. So you really can't press anything there. Let's go, Mo. I have to be honest, I'm a little bit biased towards Lunatic Soul because he's a friend of mine, but I wish Mo the best of luck. Because he's been practicing and I know that. And I would wish him the best of luck. Okay, there comes the DP. Reed Seva, but trades with the... Oh, hey. With me on commentary right now, Kuruma Barashi. So, how did you do?
I did awful. Really, like, I played against Filza, he always beats me up horribly. Yeah. I took one match, that's enough for me today.
Okay.
Alright.
It's 1-0 for Lunatic.
I see.
And the first round goes to
Mo,
who switched his character after losing with Johnny. You know, the content Fafnir is the worst thing that could happen to you because you will probably roll from mid-screen to the corner.
Yeah, he seems to struggle a bit to get his setups going.
Who? Lunatic?
No, Mo.
Oh, Mo, okay.
Seems to struggle a bit to get a setup
going. Yeah,
he just runs in instead of trying to get something out of there and gets grabbed.
Fitizen said that that Mo hasn't played in a long time.
Oh,
practically
okay.
Practically dropped the game. At FFM Rumble, he didn't play the character, so...
Oh, I see, yeah. I guess that shows because Lunatic Soul really practiced a lot.
Yeah, in the last week.
Not only in the last week, he has leveled up insanely since like the last 4 months when he really started playing, and he has really made huge improvements since then.
Yeah. I played a lot of Magic with him, and between the rounds, he always practiced Guilty Gear, and it was just because the whole week we did nothing else. We played Magic or he P-moded Guilty Gear, so I'm pretty confident that he will at least will be one of the 8 best players. And the Ground Viper, RC.
And there we go.
And that's the round for Lunatic.
That was pretty one-sided. Yeah.
The banana soul.
Alright, who's coming up next?
Okay, next up on stream, Anbi versus Chargy.
Which I'm looking forward to, I must say.
I
we haven't
think
seen them a lot against each other.
But I think, if I'm not mistaken, Chargy plays Axel.
Yeah, unless he switched, I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't think so. And Chargy actually has the matchup. Axel is a better character. He's not a better character.
I wouldn't say that, no, but...
But I think he has the matchup... I forgot the word.
You're putting shame on yourself while on stream.
Yeah.
Everyone in chat, please shame him for forgetting the word.
Shame, ding, ding, ding.
Well, I think the... only problem is really to get in there. I mean, Axel has no good defensive options. I mean, he has this DP-ish move, but Soul has a lot of options to deal with that, I think.
Yeah. But if I'm not mistaken, shame on you. Advantage! Thank you, Captain Tarma.
Alright, I have to leave.
Yeah, okay. Shame. Good luck! Yeah, I've seen it. Where's Lunatic? Oscar! So, a matchup you can talk about, Axel versus Soul.
This is so horrible. It's legit Soul's worst matchup. And I've talked to Ambi before the tournament, and he said that was a matchup he feared.
Okay.
So, we'll see how he fares. I think he has a good shot.
Yeah.
Because Chargy, I don't think he's playing as much.
Yeah.
So, he has a decent shot at least. But if Chargy can get it going with like Renz and YRC and Sparrowhawk, it's gonna be hard.
Okay. What up, people? Hey, Frosty Bolty.
Hi, Frosty Bolty. Oh, the
oh my god.
The commentary rotation is real. So my buddy just got called out for his match. So I'll see if I can get anybody to commentate with me. Well, doesn't seem to be anyone instantly coming here, so we'll see. Right now there are some button checks going on, and my good friend Owner is joining the table. So how are you doing? Oh wait, put it on first. So
I'll be facing you next.
Oh, really? Oh joy! Oh joy!
We'll be playing on stream, so
yeah, it's for top 8, right?
Yeah, that's for entrance into top 8.
Oh, man.
So win this, and you can lean back for tomorrow.
Nice. So who are you playing in losers next?
You cheeky deck waffle! Okay, well, let's get to the match. It's Faultyfault Chargy Ging Anbi, and oh!
Oh my god.
Do you
god,
know the score?
Is it with zero? The counter. Yeah, they did do a button check. So
okay,
this is
okay,
the
right into the match.
Rensen is so strong versus Sol. It shuts down a lot of his offensive
capabilities. And this almost hits him!
Nice! Good super jump. Really well.
And flame.
And Rensen going for the safe jump.
Oh no. Chargy playing too YOLO.
Yeah.
Oh, Blitz. No!
Oh, no, he can't convert. That's it. Nice.
Almost.
Oh, man. He needs to, after 5k, you need to convert to jump k.
Street Fighter is going down on 1 p.m.
So in like two hours. Roughly two hours.
2 hours from now.
So, Anbi taking the first round very convincingly.
Indeed.
We'll see
if the YOLO.
Chargy can adapt. All right. Right now, some neutral in this matchup. Chargy with the anti-air, but the Axel Bomber auto-corrects. No, it changes Sol's
direction. Change direction, no combo afterwards, but
There you see it, the Rensen YSC.
And
like,
there
Sol
is.
Doesn't really have any tools to go
Almost no
that.
Character has an answer.
Yeah.
Maybe except Jacko when she has the shield up.
Yeah.
Because it is considered a projectile.
Oh, really? Yeah.
It is a projectile.
Right.
Pots can flick it.
And
it's the only thing.
Chargy is doing it really smart right now. He's always waiting for Anbi to go for Gunflame YRC and then
he
reacts.
That's the Axel matchup. That's the Axel matchup. Axel has combos, yes, but he can't control neutrals so well with Rensen and anti-airs.
Nice first base.
But now, Anbi.
All right, nice
putting
combo.
In work.
Going for a setup.
Okay, no YRC. Okay. Just to
that
make
was,
it safe.
That was weird.
He's overthinking, I think.
Yeah. Oh,
okay,
nice. He lapped that. He lapped that. That's a good sign. Oh,
Anbi to
going for it mid-screen?
Hey. But it won't kill. But Gunfire YRC? No?
All right. Chargy also...
Just do it.
He was
make your DPs come true.
He was banking it on Chargy, just not doing FD.
Yeah. Okay, the first, UFD. The second, you think twice. But you think too slow.
All right, now Anbi up 1-0 over Chargy. Will he adapt?
Frosty Balti.
Yeah, that's true.
Our guys already checked on the Blaze Boost Station ESS commands. I think she does not have charge moves.
All right, gets the 6H counter.
Just by the way, for Frosty.
Oh no,
doesn't
get the optimal
and Revo.
Oh, is that that the Frosty?
That's the Frost Balti.
Oh, sweet.
Who organizes Revo and other events in London?
Oh yeah,
London. And
all right, now Axel bleeding, but
oh, Kudakiro just misses.
Nice throw as a punish.
Kudakiro, why not again?
Ooh, oh, that's
and
gonna be
it.
Oh no, he drops the dust loop.
Yep.
Nice mashing out of the block string.
5k, and he got it. Just barely. Ooh. Blitz shield to taunt him.
My. Alright.
Oh,
now
Sparrowhawk.
Oh no, he doesn't get the conversion. That's at its...
Oh, good counter.
Ooh, that's a lot of damage. Sadly, he wasn't cornered. That would have done like 250.
Mm. Oh. But,
nice, he gets
I
the good...
I think he's dead.
Oh my god, that's beautiful.
Go for it. Oh, one burst bait. Yeah, that was the burst bait.
That was a hard burst
bait. This should be unburstable.
Sweet, yes.
Okay, but it won't kill. Nice.
Oh, good run-up
that
run-up
was
gun flame. That was a gun flame.
Yeah, one gun frame, but just a run-up. I thought this was 6P, but it was just a run. So that is 2-0 for Ambi, very convincingly.
Yeah. He really did do
despite
well on
the matchup being in Axel's favor, actually.
Yeah, totally.
Good. Most of the matches have been played. I think we're going through the loser's side. However, I don't know what comes next on stream. We'll see in about a minute.
Alright. So who do you play so far?
I played... Oh, God. First I played Crossu, a Ramlafor player who dropped his Tekken combos. However, I had a hard time to deal with Ram because she can run away so good against Pot. But I managed...
Ooh, oh, this is gonna be a good salty run back.
That's
guys.
A salt. That's the saltiest of
Relle,
salty round backs.
Relle versus Josh.
They are both from the same German community. From the German speaking community, but on different clubs. So it's Vienna versus Munich, actually.
Yeah. Last time they both of them played, Josh won.
Josh won, and Relle was mad salty about
that.
Yeah,
that was brutal.
He wants that round back so hard.
We'll see if he put in the work.
Yeah.
Because Josh actually didn't. He has been focusing on KOF and Street Fighter.
Yeah, Street Fighter 5. Yeah, he told me himself, but he can still be pretty solid.
Yeah, totally. Josh is like, he learns it once, he never forgets. Like, yeah. Fighting games for him is like riding bikes.
Yeah, riding a bicycle.
All right.
Bicycle, bicycle. yeah. Yeah, the interesting thing on Relle is he took some time off and then played Elfeld all of a sudden. And well, now he plays her as a sub character, and I think he's going to stick with Milia for the entire tournament.
Yeah, that would be understandable.
So I
Milia's
think
really
if,
scary.
If he switches to Elfeld after a loss or begins with Elfeld, consider that round lost for him. I say
that's going to be really tough because it's only best of three.
Yeah.
Oh my.
No, he starts off with Milia, smart decision.
Alright, both of them are getting set up. Maybe we don't need button check this time around.
Yeah, come on. Button check on a button check. You can trust the system on Exart.
So.
Oh, we get the Essence Core Milia color.
So, watching out for Josh, you should especially be paying attention to the way he uses Fireball YSC. Mm. Because he oftentimes just YRCs to see, to confirm what the enemy is doing, and then air throw
you. He does the charge projectile, YRCs, runs with it, and if you jump, he just air grabs you.
That's brutal.
That's one of his neutral strategies.
Bursts out of the Oki. Alright, gets the... No, he doesn't get the full conversion.
Okay, neutral with Milia is interesting because you basically have to catch her.
Alright.
And she just waits for an opportunity to strike. Okay, Secret Garden.
Operates the guard.
Oh, here comes the Greed Sever.
Oh, it doesn't complete the combo though.
Yeah, it's lightweight. Back into the corner with you, 6H.
6H is such a strong tool.
Yeah, and on whiff it's almost completely safe. But you can blitz it easily.
Alright. The pin is out, but got in.
So yeah, Yoshi is in a difficult situation.
Oh, nice.
No burst. He might get it back, but I don't know if he wants to spend it now. Oh god.
Oh, no,
now we
he
got
won't.
The zoop zoops.
Oh my
right,
god.
Right, the lightning safe.
Oh no. No, that's not safe.
Yeah, but now it was safe there because I think Relle pressed FD and pushed him further back.
Oh yeah, then of course.
And he had, even if he landed a poke, he had no meter to convert off of it.
Yeah, that's true. Can't Milia do far as too deep? Into this for Oki?
Not on Kai, I think his hurtbox is too far on the right or left side.
Ooh, oh no,
that
that's a
could
bad
have been
burst.
A punish.
Oh man, but Relle clutches it out.
Both messed up. But now Relle has no burst left. Yosh has a full burst, ready to spend. Ooh, tries to reset, that is. Because you have to block it FD in air.
And
tries to
soon
it with Stun Edge. No, you.
A very smart tactic against Milia.
Yeah,
because
but
the pin is
he eventually has to get in. Ooh.
Alright, gets
stun
the counter hit. Stun dipper.
No! I think Yosh played too much online. Everything into Greed Sever.
Alright, nice punish.
Okay, bursts out.
Alright, good blocks, but sadly no punishes.
Yeah.
He could have just run up 5 Tatum, for example.
Yeah, a bit more stagger pressure. Not just don't press your block strings like that.
Alright,
and he's out.
This time around it should be punished. Oh.
Nope, he should have done the poke into rapid cancel and then run up.
Alright,
oh,
nice.
There's the Sato.
That's gonna be it.
Yeah, so 1-0 for Rele.
Rele goes up 1-0.
Rele, is it looking solid? Yosh. I think Yosh has a bit of a struggle.
Yeah, I don't think he has been playing it at all. Oh.
Back to character
select. Are we going to see his Elfeld? Nah, alright.
Which?
Just doing the
Yosh cabin. Elfeld?
Yeah. He's been practicing Elfeld like since he started playing.
Okay,
XR.
Okay. Never fought his Elfeld actually. No, no, I think he needs a breather. Just
yeah,
think about.
That's a good idea, oftentimes.
And yeah, change color.
Alright. Going tame on the round start by both of these guys.
Hey, hey,
right,
and
nice
we got the
combo.
Knockdown.
This time,
6-8,
midi pressure. Ooh, nice.
Oh
links.
No, this is looking much
so
better
he's
now.
On point right now. He can. Oh, alright, he wanted the increased fireball by the seal.
Ah.
Alright, now some Oki.
And we got
nice.
The overhead.
TK bad
and move. Another overhead. A burst bait. A pin into oh. Reset. Oh,
pin
this could have been baited.
Yeah, there's overhead. That's really strong.
Ooh, just.
Oh
Greed Sever.
God,
the first hit on Greed Sever. But no real knockdown.
Alright.
Oh,
oh gets
is this a
nice combo?
Combo.
Jeez. I don't think I've seen that before.
That was nice. Yosh going back.
Oh my. And that's really the same thing that was with Marvel yesterday with Benkill.
Ooh,
I think if
that was interesting hit from Rele.
Yeah.
Just
I
the
think
tip of 6k.
I think if Yosh gets the drop on Rele, like if he can outread him for like three straight times, I think Rele will be tilted. And it will be much harder for him to win this match.
Yeah, once you're broken mentally, it goes, yeah, 50% of your power is gone. And Rele has a severe
oh,
case
nice.
Of being disappointed in everything and gets worse by the minute if he keeps losing. Which is not the case on this round, actually.
Alright.
But Yosh can
but
still
Yosh
make it.
Could bring it back, yeah? Goes for the greedy.
Oh, he should have thrown that.
Alright. Rele going
just
in.
Two hits from Milia should do it. Or one throw. Oh, 5D. More safe than most 5Ds. Oh, bursts out.
Alright.
I don't know
Yosh.
If I agree with this.
I don't know.
Spending
oh.
Burst. Yeah.
Okay. He gets punished for it, so that's the thing.
Oh, PRK. Welcome. Willkommen.
Willkommen. Alright. Air dash is in. Now with the Secret Garden mix-ups.
Yeah, you have
oh,
to hold
nice.
That. Yeah, blocking low.
Goes for the
still
wire.
Goes low. Still goes
input.
Low.
Ooh.
Goes low again. And he goes hard.
Alright, really nice. It looks like he has got this in the back, but Yosh has been known for pulling off some comebacks.
This should kill, he has the meter.
Oh,
and
yeah,
burst.
That's it.
Oh, perfect!
Oh.
2-0 for Rele.
Yeah.
Which means Rele goes to top 8. We'll see him tomorrow.
Yeah, really good stuff by him.
And you know what? Whoever wins between us has to face him. Pick your poison.
It's gonna be good.
Dolly. I thought it'd go low, it just went high. You thought I'd do Mavaru? No, Nobiru.
So we're going to see a long-awaited match by me. King Rasta versus Mephistopheles. Faust versus Batman. Both of these are really, really good players.
They
so
kind of know each other. They play online, they played offline on events. So those two know each other. Especially because Rasta warned us of Mephi's level up with Batman. So we'll see, we'll see. But
yeah.
King Rasta is the favorite to take this tournament, honestly.
Yes, yes. That's... I mean, anybody who expects differently just...
Wouldn't be surprised.
Doesn't know better.
Rasta took so much... took one tournament after the another.
Yeah, he's been on a streak.
He's really been on a huge win streak.
I've heard he has like a cupboard at home with like all of the all of the trophies, medals.
Yeah, I think when he seals sells all the medals on there, all the metallic things on the medals, I think he can buy a house. All the gold.
That's the king for you. And Ige Jonas.
Sanford is unfortunately not here today or on this weekend. He dodged out
because
he
of passport problems.
Still supporting
sad.
Us from America, but unfortunately we would love to have him here. Unfortunately he couldn't make it.
Yeah.
But playing Guilty Gear, I don't know. Do you know?
I don't think he's playing Guilty.
Never really
saw
it. I think
he only
him.
Plays as a 5, so yeah, at the moment at least.
Good.
So the players are getting set up right now. We'll see, it's gonna be good. Man. So who do you think is going to be top 8?
If I remember the bracket correctly, King Rasta will probably make top 8. Rele already qualified. One of the both of us. In loser's side, I think Josh can make it to top 8.
Yeah, definitely.
He has what it takes to be top 8.
Ambi could be top 8.
Ambi.
Who is he playing against?
I don't know. Now you ask to
Kampfkicks?
Filzer.
Oh,
Filzer versus Ambi will be probably the next match
for top 8 that we see. Oh man, this is going to be great. Who's on commentary? I'm MFN Lunatic Soul, and with me...
VDV owner. And now you can actually follow me on Twitter. VDV _ owner. I mostly retweet stuff and, well... If I have a make a pot combo video, if Fab does not, I'll try. But no promises.
So, there seem to be some stick problems right now. Rasta's stick breaking down?
No.
I don't know, is he playing on some like special?
No. Nope. Just a Hori Rub 5.
Oh, sweet. Yeah, that's a good stick.
Yeah. Just right out of the box. So there are no issues with that. I think it's the PS4 that has the issues.
Yeah, it did crash earlier. Like
Yeah, great. We have the PS4 from Josh. He didn't log in.
Oh wow.
The PS4 mix-up is too strong.
So the players are now getting set up and we'll see.
Retweet dudes. That's an interesting question, Frosty. I think safe for work, but still I still need to follow some guys who post this actually. And I'm actually afraid to follow Ogawa because he always posts the...
Ogawa, man.
Yeah,
Twitter, he's crazy.
He posts the Japanese adult videos, stars.
Rasta uses an SH button?
Yeah.
What, for FD cancels?
Because Rasta actually plays Melty, and Melty has one button for parry, and that's like the same as Blitz Shield. So this is his Blitz Shield button.
Oh, I see.
He
I
wants
see.
A Blitz Shield button, which you can't blame him.
Does he use it for the drill FD cancels though?
No, I don't think so.
Man. That would be what I'd use it for.
Drill FD cancels, you need to blink and not...
No, it should be possible. You could do down K and then press
the... No, he has S and HS. You would always get Blitz Shield if you hold neutral.
Yeah, but you need to do 2K.
Anyway, back to the match. Not discussing Faust technicians. Okay, we got him. Paperback. Low. Gets him. Bomb is out.
Bomb. All right.
Paperback.
Now pushing Meffy into the corner.
Oh, burst early.
Burst early, yeah.
Another bomb.
That's oftentimes
that's the RNG Jesus.
Bursting early is oftentimes not that bad of an idea. Because
and we get the stun. But I think this won't kill. But he still gets a
good
situation.
He uses the meter to extend.
Shoki Seme! Pogo, Pogo.
Man, the Pogo stuff is so
Pogo into Pogo is
so
a frame
dirty.
Trap.
So dirty.
Pogo into Pogo.
Also, the rounds start 5D because
why not?
Invo.
It has info. Okay, neutral, respecting each other.
Destroying
and we get
the
Nage. Nage. Stone in his mouth, and here's the hammer.
All right.
And the bomb.
Oh
all the good.
God.
Oh, the
RNG.
Oh, the RNG,
oh,
and we got
sweet,
a beautiful combo.
Sweet combo.
Drill.
Oh, yo, that was dirty. Cross
and another
drill.
Bomb. The RNGs.
Oh my God.
And, oh, he fishes him out, and the mini faust.
And mini faust. This is. All right. Who do I gotta pay to
okay,
get that much?
Now
luck?
It's Mayfi's turn.
All right. Nice instant overhead.
But he has to RC for a combo.
Oh, base.
Oh, that was a mistake from.
All right. Maybe. He needs the knockdown right
just
now.
Just one hit, and it should do. No!
Oh, my God.
You think I'd bait the burst,
that.
But I'd bait the burst again.
Phew. Oh, man, that was a tough game.
That was a domey.
All right, Mephi going straight back, not taking a breather. I don't know if I agree with that.
Rasta, the king of RNG, and we get an unblockable setup. No, not for him. What's this comic? Oh, 6P.
Oh, 6P into bomb.
One for the bomb, one for the bomb. And a mini Faust. Nice. Employee of the month. We got a... Okay, drills him out.
All right, now it's Mephi's turn. Can he make it happen? Nice, gets the knockdown. Oh, I don't agree. He should, in my opinion, he should go with Bedfall
there. Out. Watch out for the recoiling. All okay, right. We got the oil.
Now pogo action. Phew, that was scary.
Hey, 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 hey. You cannot jump against Faust. Almost every button is an anti-air. 5k, right. 2k, 6p. Oh, come on. Get him in the recovery. Yeah!
Oh,
the RNG! And
everything
is alive!
Oh, man.
All according
did
to
you K see that? Two
all according to
Keikaku.
Translators know Keikaku means when.
Oh, jeez. Well.
Oh, Lady Luck.
Mephi pushing Faust to the corner.
If he got Lady Luck, he is Mr. Luck. He married Lady Luck.
Oh,
and
the hammer.
A hammer perfect for anti-air, and Mini Faust is going there like the White Shark. Dun-dun. He's coming at you. Oh, the bomb dun, dun, just dun. Out of range.
All right.
Ooh, oh, just run throw, but Rasta knows. Rasta played Batman in Sign as a sub-character, so he knows the gimmicks.
Oh, sweet.
Oh, another luck.
Oh,
but this
right.
time, yeah, just eat. Get the health back. And we get beautiful Faust voice. What? Why wouldn't you and a burst bait, and that's it. Convincingly 2-0. That's why Rasta has this enormous win streak of tournaments.
That was just a mauling right there.
And, well, we see him in top 8. Rasta too strong. I mean, almost everything in the RNG was on point.
I think
you
I'm
want
going,
a bomb, you get the bomb.
I think I'm going to sign off commentary before our match because I need you to go real quick to
the
bathroom.
Ah, oh, to the lavatory. Yeah. Oh my God, that was intense. There's a new stretch here. I mean, all those bomb gimmicks. Yeah, next up we have a Filzer, Arcade Dreams Filzer versus Gunframe Umbi. First off, Charlotte's to Umbi for the great app, Frame Data app, Gunframe. If you haven't got it yet and play Guilty Gear, you need, it's almost a must to have. You get all the frame data, everything, including minus and plus frames on block and instant block, so you can strategize everything around the game. And it's free on on Apple and Android phones. Yeah, we got some BenQ monitors from the guys from BenQ. They asked, yeah, how many do you need? Yeah, 4, but yeah, I mean, you know, we needed more. They asked like, how much? 16. Okay, we got you. Amazing. Those guys are amazing, and the monitors are really really good. Almost every tournament station is played. Almost every tournament station is played on the BenQ monitors, and I haven't seen any kind of lag. It's lag-free, just like they advertised. It's really nice. Yeah, I think BenQ might surpass Asus monitors in terms of quality and input lag. input lag, no input lag. You get my meaning. So we get to see Ambisol versus Filzer May. Both characters can lock you down pretty good. With May summons SeaWorld. And well, Sol does his usual thing with Gunframe, Gunflame, YRC. Upgate! Yeah. The hardest struggle, what theme to pick. And check your buttons, yo. I hope those guys go live this instant, because another button check in-game, it's hard to bear. Do we get the intro? Anime? Gambate! Let's do this, matey! Oh, just run up 5k. I thought that no, it was so bad. Oh, just goes for the tick throw, but this times it. Ride the dolphin. And spends the burst. Not wanting any of this SeaWorld bullshit. And another ball. But now you have to take this pressure. Bandit Bringer out of nowhere. Could have been blitzed. Filzer didn't react. DP into LC. Tries for a burst bait. Fafnir. Fafnir. Go for it. Oh my god. How many bursts do you need to bait? You ruin your whole game plan. Just take one burst and go right in back. If someone has to bait burst, then it's Potemkin. Oh god, the Great Whale. Okay, he can FD in time. Just enough meter to FD that. Okay, he goes, oh no, just DP, fuck it. I don't give a damn. Okay, one hit should do it, but oh, 6p. Much better normal than it seems. And on counter it translates into a massive damage. Ah, Volcanic Viper. You have no safe jumps, you don't respect me on wake up? Yeah, here you go, have a DP. Ah, Wild Throw just out of range. Summons? Oh, he should have gone for the air throw and not for the ground command throw. Okay, this time he respects. We got the overhead, we got the burst bait. Yeah, you cannot burst the dolphin. It's an automatic burst bait. Get all the time in the world and we get a knockdown and Sengar. Summon the dolphin. Gotta get on the dolphin. Get low, get high, and he got it. Both players, one round up. This looks pretty even. Oh, here is the 6p. No Bandit Bringer as a follow-up, but it's still enough damage. Oh no, he misses the the Ender. Okay. Summon SeaWorld with YRC, you can press a button on that. And another Dolphin. Just solid pressure. Okay, 5k to punish it. Oh no, no, no. Oh no! This should translate into massive damage. The little girl with a huge anchor. He goes low, okay. And we got a ball, and the dolphin, and the command grab into the ball. No, oh, will this be enough? Nice burst bait, mate, but not enough. No, not that bad. Okay, Filzer has a burst, so he is on the upper hand right now. And he gets it. 2k, 2d, that's one up for Filzer. PRK rocking the German slang. My brother from another mother. Oh, just a quick look at the... I'm looking at the players right now and Ambi's like... Could've killed him. Shouldn't have baited so much.
Oh,
I think Umbi hasn't got much chance to warm up. He just got here at the venue and yeah, play it right off, first game. Okay, back to the match. Both bursts already spent, so you can't. Fafnir, plus, and it goes to 2D. Oh, now we get the massive damage on 6P starter, but Mrs. D does loop, because Mei is a lightweight character. And Zengar, SeaWorld, but no meter to make it legit pressure. Gunflame, Gunflame. Oh no, that's a heartbreaker. He wanted to go for the 6H punish, but didn't get it because it was too close. He could have DP'd or normal thrown, but... Oh, will this do it? No. He just missed the conversion and Jumpy Jumpy takes it. And the Munich guys are clapping for Filzer. No surprise here. He's part of the team that brought us this tournament. Yeah, once Mei gets kinda in your head, he's like, oh my god, I'm losing against a little girl. Or a woman who looks like a little girl. Okay, Gunflame YRC. Okay, meaty Gunflame. Plus... Ooh! A. A. No! That's the third time he misses the dust loop. He's clearly nervous. I would be too. Oh no!
Look at her face! She's struggling so hard!
Oh. But this time, I think... Yeah. Don't use the burst. OTG? No! And jump S. Yeah, Lolly Rambo. Instead of a machine gun, she takes a huge anchor. Hey, hey, hey. But now, the sloop. Oh, this is the Fafnir. Okay, 6P to... Okay, that could have been a burst throw. But I think he pressed 5H and not into a throw direction. Fafnir, Fafnir. When in doubt, Fafnir third times the charm. Vulcanic Kalipa. No follow-up because he knew it would whiff. Almost gets the conversion. Umbi pretty much dropping most of his combos. Okay, that angle. Go on the offensive boy. Andy Bringer. Okay, Fizzle blocking, but the chip damage and Umbi gets it with Jump P and Jump K. Yeah, Turbo Soul won't happen with Umbi. He's no Turbo Soul user. He can't give in to the power. It's too much. Too much power. Too much responsibility. Okay, both one up. So this will be the decider. Who gets top 8 and who has to struggle in loser's side? Okay, Dolphins are out. Wow, almost a conversion. Kudakiro into nothing. Low, no. Knockdown into summon is not happening with Filzer. He's always going for Dolphin and damage. Oh my god. Too fast for you. Oh, and a reset. And this should be a perfect. What an answer. The hype is real. Okay, Umbi needs to get his game on. And oh my god, look at the wrist gauge. Two. But Filzer not having, yeah. Wake up DP. Gets a conversion, but not, oh, there we got the burst. Okay, no burst this round. 6P counted. Yeah, now he gets it. Yeah. Just go with the standard damage instead of dropping the combo. Okay, staggers and counter. This should do it. A, and yeah. Didn't even need the stun. Look at that grin on Soul. He knows. Okay, last game, last match. Let's get hype. Ringer plus. But Filzer is respecting him. A, 6P, converts, on counter, on anywhere on the screen. Fafnir just got. Oh, tries to go for Wild Throw, but Fuso mashing out. Up gates. Here comes SeaWorld. The over. I don't know if the Dolphin is on over, right? Al goes low for 2D. Conversion, no, burst wait. Oh, wake up burst. But it wasn't golden, so yeah, no meter for you. 50% on Filzer, he spends it. Both low on meter. Oh, misses the command grab. And now Ambi can finish this with one single combo. Uh-oh. 1-6P. Oh, Riot Stompu. Oh, it's 5K! He wins with the worst normal. No, not quite. Gunflame and the... What? Oh, yeah. Gunflame still active, even if you get hit. And that's 2-0 for Ambi. That was a really clutch match. Yeah, 5K anti. How did that happen? Whew, that was intense. Oh my god. Now I have to fight against my commentator partner. Someone for commentary will join you soon. This will be intense.
Okay, so. Hello. On stream it will be Ona versus Lunatic Soul. The commentators.
Yeah, that's usually in Ona's favor.
Yeah, usually.
So, Lunatic Soul sometimes takes a few rounds from him, so who knows? Ona's usually a slow starter. The first round usually doesn't go so well for him, and then he really ups his game, and then it's usually the end for the other player, but we'll see how Lunatic manages.
Is this the current patch? 5k hit the stuff.
Let's check patch. It should be the current version, yes.
Yeah, pretty sure. So they're setting up right now. So, is this sign 1.0? Yeah, pretty sure. I mean, look at the HUD.
This is sign 1.0?
Okay. Fine.
It is?
Yeah, pretty sure. So,
well, okay. In this case, guys, welcome to Dreamvolition Derby 3 Arcade 1 version of Guilty Gear Xrd, Sighing Revelator. I don't know which version we are playing now, but I guess everything goes now.
Yeah. Well, I'd bet my money on Ona, but if I want Lunatic to win this, because that would be so good. He practiced all week.
I think it would be the first time that Ona would fall into losers before top 8.
Yeah. Yeah, man. It's unfortunate. Would be cool to have you here.
Yeah, wish you were here.
Yeah, Frosty Bolty. Your name's awesome.
Hope to see you next year.
Yeah. Oh yeah, happy day. Nice. Okay, it starts. The content, right. But can convert. Oh,
goes right into the burst.
His Ona's Potemkin is really nice. You know?
Yeah, but here he will just struggle to get in against all the gun flames.
Oh yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Content, fuck me. Oh, nice.
Oh,
oh, the backdash. Really? Anime only tournament? I didn't know something.
Anime
about.
Only would be awesome. I'm all for anime games.
I like diversity, you know, seeing everything.
Who needs Street Fighter anyway?
Hey, I like Street Fighter, especially Third Strike. Tonight, Third Strike.
Yeah, but you have to admit, Third Strike is the most anime Street Fighter there is.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh! And there's the crap.
Buster!
Alright, Ona starting out pretty well.
Yeah.
Also, already has his burst back, so nothing gained for Lunatic Soul in the first round.
Back to back!
That's right, yeah.
Now he kind of has Lunatic Soul in the position where he's starting to play more defensively, which works in Ona's favor a lot.
Alpha free though. Yeah, okay, Alpha is really animated. Oh, nice backdash. Oh, rejected!
Let's shield. Oh, caught the ground shaker with the backdash. Oh, and ran to the grab.
What does that even mean? Okay. First round going to Ona.
First round is the most KO of Street Fighter.
Gimmicks.
Well, as long as it works, Ona's Potemkin gimmicks work pretty well against everyone but Rasta here, so.
Alright,
no changes from Lunatic Soul.
Yeah, he only has a soul.
Yeah.
Heaven or hell?
Alright, can he make any adaptions?
There is a start. Oh, Ona comes in.
Gets put right into the pressure again.
Oh, there's the buster!
You can kind of see that Lunatic Soul is a little bit scared of Potemkin coming at him. He just blocks a lot and gets grabbed all the time.
I mean, if he catches him only once, then he has a problem. Oh, that was nice, the backdash into the buster.
Also, awesome
match
soundtrack.
Yeah. Oh, grand wipe of the game!
Is he starting to play more crazy now?
It's always the same. If he can't do it conventionally, he always does some bullshit. I didn't say that. Oh,
no chance.
Okay.
Oh, all those backdashes from Ona, really nice.
Oh, I think this might be it. Or he will survive a sliver of health.
Way too much scaling at this point. Just needs the next combo.
Lunatic Soul is now in losers. And
Ona takes it to top 8, I think.
Top 8 winners.
Alright, okay. We have Josh versus Leoholic next.
Yeah. Josh, I think.
And Ona is back for commentary.
Awesome. Do you want to commentate, Ona? Yeah, okay.
Maybe it's Versetzen.
Okay.
Alright. That went pretty well for you.
That was a ride. That was a ride. That was the bus tour. The Potemkin bus tour. I even let you see the top of the screen. Oh,
yeah,
God.
It just looked like the Potemkin train coming at Lunatic Soul.
Choo-choo!
No way to stop it.
Yeah.
Alright, now we have Kyle versus Leo.
That is, is that Josh?
Yeah, Josh versus Leo.
Ah, Josh
Leo
versus
Holling.
Leo in loser's side.
Yeah, in loser's side.
Do you know who won against Leoholic in winners? Per chance?
I'm not sure, no.
I think I have the bracket on my smartphone.
I just met him when he already was a loser, so he fell down there right before he played against me.
Yeah.
And threw me out, but I'm not sure who it was against. That he went down to losers.
He lost against Lunatic Soul. I remember. Okay,
Lunatic
good.
Soul
okay, let's see if the Unga, let's see if Haramba is praying for him in heaven. Rip Haramba, best Leo main 2016.
All right.
Okay, he gets with the zoning.
Yeah, that's the
and
first difficulty.
What do you want to do?
Trying to get in with Leo.
Leo has his own projectiles, but Kai's are just in general better.
I mean, Leo's just takes so long to get
hold
over
that,
there.
Sir. Good block on the high, but Grito Sever.
And we go to the corner.
Hey, and we get the corner set up into Split CL and no!
Oh, and gets the
beat. Yeah, aim for the skies. If you don't hit them, you can still YRC. RC. I like that meme the most. Oh, God. Tries to go with the...
Oh, gets the grab.
Yeah, fuck yeah, you. Not happening. You have to read harder. You have to read harder.
That won't work against Josh.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, now Leo can soon him, but he has to go first.
Yeah, he has to get...
Oh god, goes
first.
High, goes high. Hey, hey, Ender. Oh, Sunday.
Can't approach him. Josh is always the one dictating the pace.
Leo is a bit too reluctant to press some buttons now.
Oh,
oh
nice
yeah.
challenge.
That's an answer to that. And that's another answer.
You can
oh,
DP, I
what
can
the
DP
second
too.
DP? DP, RC, DP, the best combo ever.
Nice.
Yeah, 1-0.
Very convincing from Josh.
1-0 for Josh. Sin is not unplayable. He just got nerfed and became more normal. He still deals a lot of damage.
Oh, we're
even
gonna see
though
a change.
He got nerfed on damage. Oh, Leo, please don't. Yeah, okay. Stick with your main, bro. Stick with your main.
Has he tried any other characters?
Yeah.
Or?
Kai, for instance.
All
so
right.
Basically, he should know the character. But the matchup is a different topic.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if.
Oh,
no. Oh
that
oh,
hurts.
Heartbreaker.
That hurts.
That was a Domi. Domi burst. Okay, 5H hits on both sides and beats Greed Sever. I'm okay with that.
Oh, what?
Yeah, you can low profile Kai's DP. It has no hitbox on the ground.
Oh.
So any low moves like Leo's stance K on good spacing will, well, evade it.
Alright, now he has a bit of pressure.
If you instant block 5H, you can throw the first hit of Wrecker. And even the second. Yeah, the second is even slower.
And Josh's defense just on point here. All those instant blocks really works out.
Oh no. He misses the link. He got the hit. He could have linked into pressure, but yeah. 1, 2. Ah, tries for cross up, but Josh throws it. And
oh,
here we have
the
overhead. Hey, hey, but now, come on, split CL Ender.
And
hey, hey, yes, now we get the Oki. Okay, it goes high again. 6H, 6K.
And just no answer from Leo Holic. Tries to get out.
Now
oh,
he gets the cross up. Overhead, into, blowing,
just
into, 6H, into.
Right away.
Hey, hey, hey.
And
hey.
That really hurts.
Oh! Okay, this is what happened. Josh wanted to throw, got the 6H out, but 6H was too slow to get to be caught by the parry, and this is what killed him.
Yeah.
That's really sad.
And just
he did
like
everything
that,
right,
it's over.
But 2-0, good play from both of them, especially in match 2. But now, Josh top 8, just like I predicted earlier. And now we have the brother of Leo Holic, his younger brother, RFK, which is the acronym for his full name, Anton Friedrich Klemm. He used to, what was his nick before? Antonic. Yeah, right.
Ah.
Leo Holic, Antonic. Yeah.
That's the name I remember.
Yeah. Fisch, mit der Aussage würde ich aufpassen. Er hat den Wifebeater an. Du magst 500 Kilometer weiter entfernt sein. Beim nächsten Event, er merkt sich alles. Ah, Mephi gegen Anton. Genau, Mephi gegen Anton. Ah, ja, ich glaube, das wird dann. Wenn ich einen Guess machen würde. If I would make a guess, I'd say this one goes to Mephi.
Just do they have any experience against each other?
Yeah.
he has almost no experience. Only when King Rasta played Batman and AFK got some experience, but not that much to really. And since Rasta started to main Faust and here and there play Raven a bit, but no more of his old subs from Sign, we have no Batman experience in our clubs. So yeah, we still have it from online, from tournaments, but 100% matchup knowledge not happening.
Yeah. All right. There's something going on at the stream station.
Yeah, player 2 has to log in.
Controller problems as always. Huh. Thanks, PlayStation 4. Now we're getting somewhere.
Yeah, now it's gonna get down. Bitoman. What? Ah, Japanese version. Slayer. Even though Slayer has been said to be low tier, you can't put him down. One, pile bunker, and you're, well, kiss goodbye to 70% of your health. So,
let's see how that
goes. On the other side, I don't know if Mephi has so much experience against Slayer. However, he can zone him out. Because Slayer has only teleport. That's all he has against projectiles. And maybe that's all he needs. We'll see.
Also, both characters, pretty crazy dashes that will be interesting in the corner.
Okay, first blood goes to... Not yet.
Not yet.
Probably Mephi.
Getting a few...
Oh, still blocking, still blocking, still blocking. Oh, okay,
ah,
first blood on Mephi. But, oh!
But here we go.
First damage combo goes to Anton.
Damage. Oh, but drops kind of
out
there.
But good block here. Respect the bat. Oh, yeah, that's a punish.
Yeah.
You whiff the bat. Oh! Yes, that's the burst bait. Yeah. Automatic, has invul. Oh, goes for low, goes for A, A high, it's plus,
and here is the 2,
that was the 6H. Always respect the 6H.
That gets out.
You're in air, you think, nah, that's not gonna hit me.
Oh, crosses up, nice.
It's gonna hit you. But now Mephi, no meter for sufficient mix-up, but still got some seals out. And yeah, one
now
dead on time.
Setting him
and
yeah, oh yeah, there we go.
Oh shit, yeah, could this be it?
Oh, hey,
almost!
Oh, but
the shoulder.
Right enough.
Oh, and clutches it out. Nice! Sorry that I'm biased. that's a point from my club!
Completely fine.
And it's Slayer! Who isn't hype about Slayer? In Ixard. Okay, Essence Core, I can understand you don't like him.
Just okay. Like a bit of a zoning game right now.
Okay, no punish on the blitz.
Oh, nice.
And all black beat combos.
Just doesn't let him approach. Oh,
okay.
And now he gets put
picks him up in the air, no follow-up.
Oh, and now he's in the corner. Now the game starts.
Yeah, overhead into nothingness. Another overhead. Mappa hunch.
Oh, jumping again.
Tries to suck some blood. Ah, 2H buffed. Fortunately. Another 2H. Ooh, Pailu Bunker! Pailu Bunker!
That's gonna hurt.
Oh, tries to go for reset or burst bait. Ah,
oh,
catches him. Oh, this could... This could be bad for him.
Oh, but drops it. Both still sitting on their burst.
Oh, almost! But the burst!
Yeah.
No!
There we go.
Oh my god!
There we go.
AFK learned burst base. What year is it?
Oh, it's current year, don't you know?
Slayer hype. Oh yeah. I did not expect that. I said burst bait, I did not believe he would burst bait. Commentator's curse on the plus side. So I will say, yeah, he will drop everything now. Okay, opens him up low. Now Mephi on the offensive, crosses him up.
Again, gets the repeat, okay. Oh, overhead.
Another,
cross up
another
again.
Cross up. Another instant overhead.
Yeah.
But now no finisher real, but it's still okay.
Interesting.
Okay,
wow.
That was a nice combo with the projectile.
Now he's just having fun.
Okay. But a good decision not to burst from AFK because that was low health. Better save it for round two. Hey, okay, he tries to mix him up always. I can understand why he does not end with a Mappa Hunch because it puts you in neutral state and another
oh,
burst state.
Oh, nice.
Take
one.
That.
And gets put in the corner.
Hey, hey.
Oh,
and into Pailu Bunker. Pailu Bunker.
And that's gonna hurt.
Hey, 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 hey. Hase, are you watching? That's your son.
Gets him low.
Oh, what a... Ah, the cross to up.
Cross up again.
Oh, oh. Tries to blitz, but he goes low.
And now
that's,
we just get
could
all
be
the corner pressure.
And here we get...
And here we get...
Heavy.
The sheep comes in.
You should teleport to him.
Oh,
Knight.
Denies it.
Oh, almost hits the pylon.
Oh, I guess
he gets it.
What
the fuck?
Hell?
What the fuck?
What kind of
Axis, please?
What hitbox bullshit was that?
What? Well, still won. Whatever.
I can't believe it.
Holy fucking shit! Okay, clutch out.
Right.
Overhead.
Overhead. No. All the mixes.
Oh, good, oh, good teleports from Anton. Oh, oh, hey, 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 you pie bunker. Hey, 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 hey. But Mephi has burst. Oh, he could have grabbed him there. There could have been a reset.
Oh, oh! That's done. Are we going to see another burst phase?
No.
This time, no.
One hit. One hit. One hit, two.
Oh!
Grab him. Grab him. Yes. Oh, my God. What a victory.
We full anime. Yes, we
are.
We
full anime. And AFK, Anton Friedrich Klemm eliminates Mephistopheles from the Guilty Gear bracket. Whew.
Wow.
I did not expect this kind of level up from AFK. Holy shit. Then Danair, an Austrian player, who is not part of VDV because he lives too far away to attend weeklies or anything. Mm. He just comes to monthlies if he has the spare time and the money. Or, yeah, kind of like that. And, yeah, Arcade Dreams Filzer, one of the, well, part of the crew of the organizers of this tournament here, playing Mei, lost very close to Anbei.
Yeah, that was...
Oh my god, this weekend, I think my voice is gonna break down.
I'm already like, I think I caught a cold yesterday already. Like, convention flu, something like that.
Yeah, with over 100, roughly, yeah, 100, we got 100 registered players, so yeah.
Yeah.
If one has a cold and meets you, well,
and
better
here,
wash your hands.
Here in the cellar, like, no air circulation, it's gonna spread pretty fast.
Oh, we have some air ventilation here. Just on the side, because it's not a real AC, but it still provides a fresh
so that
air.
We don't all suffocate.
Because actually we're on the ground, but one of the best locations
you
can have in Germany. This is not just a rented room or a kind of dance kind of building you just. Build up some tables and have some monitors. No, this is an esports club.
Yeah.
So this is built for our purpose.
Usually,
even though we're a niche community of esports.
Yeah,
however, on the rise, maybe we got Capcom Pro Tour, but not on this event because, well, we have mixed feelings about that.
Yeah.
Or Capcom said, well, no, we already have what we already had one event in Germany. Why two? Now, anyway, we still had a lot of support,
Speaking of which, support, we got P-Cube's Nathaniel Hockey here, who provided us with not one, not two, not three, but four stations of Blazeblue Central Fiction.
Super hype for that.
This is one of the best things on this tournament if you are a Blazeblue player. I am myself, and I can't get enough of it. Just one little negative thing about that, you can only play versus, so no training mode, no challenges, but hey, versus is all we need, basically. You can even train combos if you just plug in a controller and, well, player 2 is just idle.
And you really need to, a lot has changed in the versions, it's really
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, and shout out to Dustloop for actually writing down some combos for Central Fiction for most characters.
Yeah.
I don't, always, know, I don't know every work. Character section in Dustloop, but the Tsubaki section is pretty okay, actually. On CF. I got some combos from that. Should be enough. So, we got Filzer with Mei and then Danair
with Raven.
With Raven. Indeed.
So
the first Raven in the tournament. Rasta did not play Raven in the tournament, obviously, because...
Yeah, no experiments there.
No experiments, no second guesses, no chances, no, just go with Faust.
This is going to be interesting, because Filzer, except for what he got like on this very weekend, has no really experience except for online against Raven, so... Mm. We'll see how he deals with that. Does Danair have any experience against Mei?
Not that I know of. But he plays online, so let's see. Maybe he played in casuals. We'll find out.
Let's see. We are watching the full Animu intro. And here we go.
Okay, they play neutral, respect, zone each other out. Raven not throwing the pin yet. Hey,
oh,
hey,
hey,
here goes the fly,
and there
we
go. Goes. And we go.
The Raven train is on the run, but
jumps out.
Drops are confirmed. Grausame Richter sich.
And that's just so scary when that projectile comes at you.
Couldn't confirm off
another
the command throw because no excitement level, but
and
a reset.
Again.
Okay, that was not a legit setup. And slam it.
Again!
Use your meter! Oh, almost reads him correctly. He read him correctly, but just not hit.
Oh, can't get the setup.
He has all the meters. Spend it, please.
And that should be it.
I think Filzer tried reversal super there.
Could be, yeah.
But should be frame perfect. Oh, a hard guess.
No. I think it really shows a bit that he is maybe not 100% sure what to expect from Raven. I mean, it's not a character you see that much online since you have to unlock him at all.
Yeah, kinda. But now SeaWorld's got him locked down. He just jumps in the corner. Filzer not doing anything against that. Could have air thrown him three times there. And now we get
Oh, but can't convert. Tries it again with the
fighting
cross
against
up.
Raven is one thing. Learning combos on Raven is the other.
Oh, gets him with the Lotus
and
time and the grab again.
Scharf Zweig.
All those.
Super.
Germanish names.
Why
oh,
would you reset? Yep, 1-0 Danair. I hope Filzer is not mentally broken now. Because Filzer tends to overthink things.
Yeah.
Like,
she already was.
I got hit by that and that and that. Processing. No, the match is continuing.
She already was pretty shaken when he fell down to loser's side.
Yeah, that was a heartbreaker, honestly.
Yeah.
He did so well against Ambi and then, well, it was clutch.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just, yeah, confidence in himself and confidence in the Raven matchup. Both things that he needs to consider.
Went for the grab there, but missed it. Now, nope. Oh, nice.
This time, Mei was too much of a
monster. Oh, but gets the shielded. But gets no setup. And now, Mei is on the roll again.
Oh, tries to grab him. Oh, that's the
tries
ball.
That a lot now. Oh, but this time he challenges the Omad. Tries to get the SeaWorld going in the corner. And looks...
Oh,
got burst.
I don't know if he could have baited that with the air dash. But still good damage.
Oh, gets grabbed again. One hit. For massive damage.
It's a follow-up combo due to the excitement meter you see on the left. Left corner. Left down.
Oh, nice.
And finally gets around. Is this the comeback of Filser? Did he finally wake up?
Now on the advantage. Dana, you still need some time to get the burst back.
Yeah. While Filser still has burst ready to use. To get out of Raven's
vortex.
And we got the reset on Filser's side. And all the damage. Yeah, Raven cannot take much hits.
And now we'll get the SeaWorld again.
And the low and the high. Pushes him out with FD. Nice there.
Oh.
But the ball. You always have to consider the ball.
Oh, good nice. Punish.
And now one burst spin and... Yeah, it was golden.
But can't punish the burst. Gets
this reset is... Filser needs to get out of that.
Oh, almost got in there.
Now
again.
We get SeaWorld.
Got the overhead.
And
that's
whoop,
it.
Whoop, 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 and the whale. Free Willy.
Doesn't even need to whale.
There it is. No? Oh, you can't do follow up when you're winning.
Oh, there's coaching from Rasta.
Yeah. Rasta can't let his sub-character suffer. And yeah, repping Austria.
Sadly, no one from Munich who could coach Filser on doing anything better. We all have no idea what to do against Raven.
Ambi is nowhere to be found, so
yeah,
he could have coached it.
All right, here we go again. Oh, Cornus attempt for the dust there.
Could have baited that. Grausame, I can't hear the rest, even though I'm German.
Got out there with the ball.
Gets him the pin. You have no movement now, sir. Ah, good. Keeps it safe. But the ball, give me the ball. Give me the ball. I need that excitement. To be honest.
Oh, nice one.
Yeah. Raven needs this excitement meter. Otherwise, you have to do, five combos to get...
Oh, but gets caught by
the dust. Ender, but it won't kill. But SeaWorld will be summoned. Lock him down, but I think he was respecting the reversal super.
Yeah.
Ooh,
up
like a ripe fruit!
Oh, nice. And gets bit chilled again. This is the third time that's happened now.
6H? Why? Okay, the zoning is real. Almost gets him, but Mei is the queen of the air.
You can't just do anything against an anchor.
Mei, air-to-air is really hard. You need really good air-to-air normals.
Gets the overhead again. And
now he gets
low,
bursts out. Doesn't want any of that.
And puts him in the corner. Oh,
almost.
No, gets out.
Maybe he should have held 6H more to get the hit. Now,
again.
Does not go for the knockdown, but for the reset. That's the fourth time.
This time everything's locked.
Okay.
I get the air grab. But no setup.
Filser needs to attack him. Yeah, and we
there
get
we go.
Look at that damage. Summoning SeaWorld gets the cross up. Oh my
now,
god. I didn't know.
One more. He needs to get rid of the burst too. There
almost.
It is. There it
almost.
Is. One hit.
Oh! Wow. Usually that hits.
And Filser takes it.
Filser takes it. So we have a Mei in top 8. In loser's side. And now?
Antic versus Lunatic Soul.
Both are Soul players. Soul Mirror match. Let's go. Okay, on the right side we got Lunatic Soul, on the left side we got Antic. Lunatic Soul picking Banana Soul.
As well, always. Antic,
yeah, Antic goes with the Green Soul. So we should distinguish both of them pretty smoothly.
Yeah.
May ship with the old theme, Blue Water, Blue Sky. Soul on Soul action. Who's got the better fundamentals? Let's see how they start. Okay, Fafnir.
Oh.
Okay. No full combo yet. Gundam Flame.
They're just trying to get a solid confirm on each other.
Okay, respecting the gun.
Oh! Ooh,
but he was ready. Antic was ready. TP on Wake Up.
Oh,
it could have baited that. It could have baited. He was walking forward. Yeah, the
right
second
away.
TP. Tries to get
okay. Sweep.
Right, Stomp with NYSC is the best backdash in the game.
Oh,
ooh,
it
catches him with
there.
The buff here. And he cannot burst that because he has no
that
burst.
That really hurts.
And he has the meter for a full mix-up.
Oh,
the
overhead.
Late overhead! The late overhead! Nice! Ah, tries for a 6H.
Oh! Tried to grab there, but missed again!
Yep. What? Why Riot Stomp? Okay, Fafnir.
Catches the jump. Oh, and an MTDP.
Okay.
Bursts out.
Nice!
Nice one.
He knows his frame data. I mean, it's his character. What?
Oh,
5D?
Fafnir against the dust.
Okay, 6H. No, that was not a counter hit, sir.
Oh, I get to sweep again.
That was a safe jump, so...
He tries to grab so often, but never gets it.
5K, and in an ender. Let's see if we see a DP. No, 5K. Ooh, this is a combo.
Oh,
and a burst mate as well!
Nice one.
Soul's air hurt box is a bit weird.
Can't catch him there.
No conversion of that. Antic misses so many combos.
Oh, okay, and now he gets the grab.
And he got it.
And Lunatic Soul takes the first match.
Dear Technician, could you please give us the schedule link for today? Otherwise, you find everything on DreamVolutionDerby.de. Well, it's in English, don't confuse us because we have the DE domain. We find everything, the schedules, the players who are entered. We have over 100 registrations.
It's the first time we're going full international on the stream today too.
Yeah, English, mandatory.
I actually think that makes commentary a lot easier than doing it in
German. Yeah, commentating fighting games in English is much.
Plus you hear so much more of it in English.
You can't do the German memes, but you can, well, English, you hear it everywhere. Yeah. So
and now pretty good from Antic here. Oh!
Reject. Antic this time more aggressively.
Yeah.
But Lunatic Soul is striking back.
It's not
gets
over
him with
yet.
The 5k, bust out. Fafnir. Almost
in the corner. And another Fafnir.
Wow. He didn't even go for the easy ender, now go for the full dust loop. Show us your skill. You sneaky bastard. Oh, well,
he really likes that grab.
Well, Soul is part grappler. OK, Okay, that was plus, but still backs up.
I like that he still got the confidence, though, to try it after, in that earlier round, it failed three times in a row.
No dust loop from Antic.
Catches Wood him out of the air.
Knockdown from Lunatic Soul. And a wild
throw. One.
Can he make it burst safe? He tries to, but misses it. It's black beating.
Drops out.
Kudakero into YSC. And no chance to burst
just that. Like that.
And just like that, Lunatic Soul advances into top 8.
Nice.
Turbo Soul is, it's only Turbo Soul once one goes into DI.
And
so we got
it?
Our top 8. We got our top 8.
Alright guys, that's it for Guilty Gear for today.